Hello friends, welcome on this video tutorial. Daniel is here from Tips to Fix, and today in this video tutorial I will show you how to add your business email address on your Outlook, okay, in your Android or in your iPhone, also in your desktop, okay, or a Mac. It will be the same because the Microsoft Office Outlook, it's the same in both platforms, okay? So continue watching this video tutorial. If you have a work email address like I do, like I have it here, I'm here on my web host, okay? So I'm using cPanel control panel to host my website. I mean, to manage the server for my website. And here I have ability to create email addresses because also I have web server here. One of the things how you can directly get access on your webmail on your business website, if you go here on, let's say in my case is tips to fix, and if you write slash, and then if you write here webmail, you will get access on webmail. You just need to put your username and password to check your emails on your website. Let me check right now. Look at this. I have a lot of emails here. This is the fastest way that you can get access on your mail server. Now let's continue to configure it in Outlook. If you see here, I have created an email address, test@tipstofix.com. If I click here connected devices, then here you can get all information that you need. This is the information that we need to configure it on our Outlook, okay? So open up your Outlook, and here on your Microsoft Outlook, go to file here and then add an account. I will configure this test. I'm using the latest version of Outlook, I think. Using Outlook, you will have multiple email addresses. If you have three or four businesses and then you want to have all email addresses in the same place to manage all of emails, here it is. Outlook is the best for that, okay? So very important is that you need to know difference between IMAP and POP3. If you use POP3, it will download all emails on your computer, then it will be deleted from your server, okay? But in most cases, you need to have emails on the server, also on your computer, then my suggestion is that use IMAP. This is what I usually do or use for my clients, okay? I use IMAP for them. They don't want emails to be deleted from the server. But in the case that you don't want emails to be on the server, for security reason, you don't want your IT guy to watch and see and check your emails and read them all, use POP3. They will be downloaded on your computer. The fastest solution is that you will use this IMAP, okay? IMAP server. Let me see here. Look at this. mail.tipstofix.com. Incoming and outgoing server will be the same. mail.yourdomainname.com or net or whatever. And then just click mail. mail.tipstofix. And then the same thing. So this is the mail server, okay? And then encryption method, I will use this SSL TLS. To use IMAP on Outlook, you need to use this port 993. And then I suggest this method, secured method, SSL and TLS. Settings recommended because you don't have to get affected from viruses. This method is more secure. The security will be SSL TLS like I did it here, okay? And then encryption method will be here, SSL TLS. And then I will click continue, but first of all, I will change this port. Outgoing server port is this one here. SMTP is 46465. Click next. You will be required for password. I already have my email password. Username, it was full email. Look at this, account add successfully. As you see, as IMAP is working great, and I have here server, let me check and send emails. I get an email here, so I received an email. Microsoft Outlook for testing, welcome. Okay, and I have here emails that downloaded from server. But I will delete now and I will reconfigure it, but with POP3, not IMAP. If you're wondering to use POP3, for the moment they change the security on that. It will doesn't work in a security mode, okay? But you can choose port 110 on POP3, okay? I will show you. I will try. Let's go and add again. test@tipstofix.com. And I will connect it. I will use POP3. If you're wondering to use this POP3 now, I will use this non-secure port 110, okay? Mail. So this is the mail server, okay? And this will be the same. In my case, this is my mail server. You have another mail server. You have to open up your documents and then see where you have the email configuration from your server, okay? Ask your IT guy on your work and then they will give you these ports and passwords for you, okay? Non-security, IMAP or POP3, I will use 110. Let's see if this will work here. For outgoing, I will use SSL, okay? And port 465, password here, and then click connect. So POP3, it's working well. Let me check my emails here, my inbox. Try to get and send messages. Here it is. I have emails here on the Outlook, okay? But if you try to connect the POP3 and security method, then you will not be able to use it for the moment. And the port 995465. Connect. And let's see if this will work. Something went wrong, okay? I have here all information that you need, but it's a lot of work to do to configure that, and I don't suggest you use it. It's because they changed the authentication method. What you can do is you use Thunderbird, okay? It's more easy for you guys. You will see that in another video. I'm here today to show you only Outlook, okay? This is how you can configure email address on Outlook in your Windows or in your Mac. It will be the same thing, okay? Let me show you real quick how to configure it on your mobile. So now let's configure my work email address on latest iPhone, okay? iPhone 14 Pro Max. So what we have to do, first of all, go to your Apple Store and then search for your Outlook. Here it is, Microsoft Outlook. Then I will do an update. I mean, you have to install it if you don't have it. But I did an update for me. So let's open up Outlook on mobile right now. If you have to add an account, click that add an account. It requires you to log in on Microsoft. I don't want to log in on Microsoft right now. Close this and I will click this button here, skip, okay? So if you click that skip button, then you will see this next window. You will be able to add an your business email address here. Add an account. You only see here IMAP at the end. Then I click here IMAP. Put your email address here. And then display name is here. You can put your name. All of these fields here that you will put it here, it will be displayed as a name when somebody receive your email, okay? So it's important to make this right. Job prescription here or something, okay? So mail server will be, in your case, mail.yourdomainname.com or whatever. IMAP port. If you wanted to use security mode, I told you, you have to put your IMAP port 993. So it will be the same to you also, okay? Port security, SSL, I need that. IMAP username. Your username will be your full email address. Okay, here it is. The password will be your email password. SMTP outgoing server, email server will be mail. SMTP port, look at this. Security port is 465. Use this. 465. Port security, SSL, okay? SMTP username will be the same with your email address. Paste it here and put the password again. Sign in now. On your way, click next, getting better, accept, continue to Outlook, maybe later. Okay, turn on notification. So here it is, let me check my emails, go to inbox, look at this, I have two emails here on inbox, focused, another one, look at this, other, this is the email that I have. Let me try to send an email to my tips2fix@gmail.com. And then I will receive an email. I received this email that I just sent it. If you go to send, you will see that I sent this email, okay? And let me type this, it works. Okay, So thank you for watching this video tutorial. If you have any questions or difficulties how to configure your work email or business email address, let me know, okay? Don't forget to subscribe Tips to Fix. I'm here to do a lot of videos like this and help you guys. God bless you. See you on the next video tutorial.